through fear and our presentation, beginning of the Community Talent Showcase. We'd like to remind you at this time that the use of flash photography and recording devices during the performance is prohibited. Now, please sit back with us and enjoy an evening of entertainment.
In order to play with this record, you must tune your bass to a
happy. think I'm not talking to you, but I really am talking to you, okay? I neglected to introduce myself, assuming you all knew who I was. No, my name is Pamela Sayu, and I will be your mistress of ceremonies tonight, as well as some of the things I got myself involved in. But I'm excited because this is a real good show, and I'm so glad that I'm involved so deeply. I would like to introduce our next artist. He is specifically our guest artist. He teaches vocal and guitar lessons. And you can also catch him on Sunday with his band at the On Broadway, performing on Sundays for this month, the 15th and the 29th. He'll be performing two songs at this time. His name is Moses Randolph, by the way. Moses Randolph will be performing one song called Brandy, written by Walter Williams, and the second song is called Big Shot, and it was written by himself. Please help me welcome a very good friend of mine, a very talented man, Mr. Moses Randolph.
Okay. It's really hard to see.
And I'm really happy that people asked me to be a part of this. I see a lot of kids here tonight, and that's what's happening. You know, we have to share this gift, give it to the kids so they can carry it on in good fashion. That's what my whole message is about tonight. The first song, though, Brandy, this is just a song I love. It's about a guy in his life.
Sitting by an open fireplace, in my day without reading, I hum a few bars of melody, and it sounds good to me. Thought I'd get up and take a look around, with my feet got in the way. I can see the blood running to my heart, through my window pane. How could it be? She ran away from me. My best friend's gone, and I'm so all alone. I kinda miss you, Brandy. Missing you every day. Are you going home today?
The song about the gift.
Okay. Wanna see it too? Midnight City, golden dreams. Trying to be a big shot. Need them wings of precious things. Come half strut and bebop with your right hand lady in diamond ring. Folks say he's forgot the land from which he came. Says he doesn't need his old friends, cause he's found like new. Says he can't use his good friends, cause he's found them too. But I knew the boy when he wasn't sitting so pretty. He liked the sound of a great big city, fast and hard, of a town women from a factory farm. Nitsy, gritsy, ain't a big enough city for a day shop. Well, he's living in a penthouse, out here on the streets, working on the overtime, just to make ends meet. No one knocking on his door. No one's calling out his name. And he can't find his new friends, cause they don't like losers. And he can't find his old friends. Lord, he sure could use one. But I knew the boy when we went back and we walked in. Far as we ever got to the great big city, we shall phone a star, playing our music from a back street bar. Nitty gritty ain't a big enough city for a big child. I know you well, oh, you should have had a big heart instead. We came from a small town, I wasn't all alone when I died. I knew the boy when he wasn't sitting so pretty. He liked the sound of a great big city, fast and hard, uptown women from a factory farm. Nitty gritty ain't a big enough city for a big child. Hey, 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 hey. I knew the boy when he wasn't sitting so pretty. Sound of a great big city, fast and hard, uptown women from a back street bar. Nipsey Ripsey ain't a big enough city for a big child. He came from a small town, wasn't all alone.
Performed by Greg Kelly. Greg is playing Santana, a Vietnam vet, and telling a friend that he feels responsible for a friend's death. He would like to perform this monologue in honor of all veterans of war. Please welcome Greg Kelly.
Sergeant got it first, right on the side of his face. And then Milks got it. I just started running. And then we got a killer, he was right behind me. And we just ran. We just ran through the bush. And we just hid. We didn't know what to do. We didn't know where to go. We just hoped they wouldn't come after us. It wasn't fair, they weren't supposed to be there. They were supposed to be miles north of camp. But there they were, they were all over the place. I hadn't seen anybody get killed before. The next thing I knew, two of our friends were dead. And we were dead. Coward, he just kept looking at me with those big eyes, trying to figure out what we could do. Sensor are going down, so we dug again. And we dug and we dug. So we couldn't dig anymore. Killer. He just kept looking at me with his big eyes. Just two of us alone in the jungle, in the dark. It's so dark we couldn't even see our hands in front of our faces. And then I started thinking about the boot camp out. They told us that Marines were tough. Marine never gave up. I never thought I'd be like this. I was only 19. I hadn't done anything or seen anything. I didn't want to die. Even if I did die, they wouldn't have anywhere to send a body. Killer, he kept calling out to me. Making sure I had him in that arm. I tried to shut him up. He's scared too, I guess. And then the Vietnamese picked up on it. Hey, Santana, You're gonna die! I just kept it up all night. Well, at least it probably does not. And then I heard it. The twig snapping. That night I died every time twig snapped. I died a thousand times that night. But, and then I heard the bodies crawling and scraping against the ground. I knew they were coming after us. Before I even heard it. Anyway, I grabbed my rifle, I pointed at the noises and I just started shooting. I couldn't see them, but I could hear the screams as my bullets found their bodies. I just kept shooting and shooting, so I ran out. And I just leaned back against the wall of the foxhole, and I just waited. I waited till first sunup. And I heard a footstep. I followed up. I leaned back and I waited for it to come. Hey Santana, you okay? It was Colonel Bridges. I didn't realize that then until Colonel Bridges pulled me out. It was killing her. He was just laying there with bullet holes all over him. I didn't know he was there. He was just lying there with his head cut off.
She's 11 years old. She's in the fifth grade and goes to school in Portland. She lives in Hood, California and has been taking singing lessons for a year and a half. And she will sing one of my favorite songs in the whole world. It is called Part of This World from The Little Mermaid. Thank you. Oh, I know. I keep switching sides. I get bored. Wasn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
See, that's what she has. She's a beautiful girl. She's cute. She definitely has a gift. A year and a half? You know? And you say, doesn't make you sick. Okay, anyway. We do have another wonderful singer coming up. Her name is Jessica Simpson. And she's a native Californian and has been living and working as a nurse in Sacramento since 1987. She sang in her high school and college choirs, but only recently began singing solo. She currently studies voice and piano and is a member of the Northern California Vocal Artists Association. She enjoys singing old standards as well as contemporary songs. She has performed in 2 singing contests and has sung at weddings for friends. She does it a lot. Let's give Jessica Simpson a nice warm welcome.
Thank you.
so it helps much just the touch. We need visual aids. Okay. Oh, God, there you guys are. Great. Oh, you're there. That's cool. First of all, I want you to, visual aid, okay, you know, in your program, in the back, there's a letter. Well, basically, it states the purpose of this showcase. And I wanted to take this opportunity to mention that to you because basically it's this connection. It's the in-between. It's what we're doing here on stage and what you guys are doing down there. It's performing for you as an audience, lovers of music and performing arts, as well as for agents and record producers and modeling agents and casting agents. And you know what I'm saying? It's a networking thing, and I think it puts it in a nutshell right there in that letter. So I do, it's at the back of the program, but I do want you to take a moment and look at that because that's the purpose, and I think it's real important. It's, basically, it says that this is our answer to the Apollo. You know, and that's, I mean, not to compare ourselves with that by all means, but to say that there's a lot of talent here in Sacramento, Northern California, and we want to tap that, and we want you to be able to see what's up here. So this is a start, and it really, really depends on us, the community. And I think it's great that you guys came out to support us tonight. Thank you very much. Give yourselves a hand. Okay, secondly, because I have the lights up. Well, you guys just thought you were going blind, right? Wait! I do want to introduce the special guests that we have. I think you can all notice the golden circle section here. I'm going to introduce the people that are here so far tonight. Like I said, we want to invite people who can make a difference for our performers. And I'm going to introduce some people that will. No, just kidding. Ooh, where are you guys? You're going to go right. First of all, Mr. Larry D. and Mr. Charles Gwynn from Playhouse Records. Can you just raise your hand, shake your booty, do something? Thank you. Thank you for coming tonight. Then we have Mr. JD from Sub-Zero Productions. Where are you? Finally, we have Ken Phelps. Where is he? Huey Bryant, agent. He's going to be coming on in a second. Huey Bryant. Where are you, Ken? I also want to mention to you that, you know, you're seeing a lot of good talent up here tonight, but if you know of anybody that, under your breath, you know, I know somebody who knows something better than that. Well, did you understand what I just said? Because I did kind of say it under my breath. Well, you do, let's get them up here on stage. Let's give them a vehicle, some way to showcase what they can do. Okay? Yeah, I think so. Yeah. My friends right there. Okay. Without further ado, I promised myself I'd never say that, but without further ado, we have Lindsay and Kelly Fields, singing sisters. Lindsay and Kelly are currently, thank you, Lindsay and Kelly are currently studying voice with James Arnold. They both have been playing piano for 3 years under the instruction of Irv Boshe, their grandfather. Both girls have performed in Broadway Academy plays under the direction of David McDonald. Lindsay is 11 years old and Kelly is 9. Please welcome the Field Sisters in their debut performance of Sisters. Sisters, there were never such four sisters. Never. started acting at the age of 6. Apart from acting, he sings and choreographs dance sequences. He plays the violin and the bongo. When he's not acting or being an engineer, he likes to discuss human behavior. He also enjoys watching the sunset. Today he will be performing a monologue from It's a Wonderful Life, Mr. Steve Anantantalai.
They've been playing in a group called Mystique, but together, just the two of them, they form a group called Hot Pursuit. Tonight they perform Talk About Love. Hot Pursuit.
Heart and soul. the very best of me.
Destroy the love, it's our way. We Some songs are sent
my chosen man. So for a minute and say, groove, baby, on the right side, you're looking good. When you're dancing, na 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 na, listen to the words of this song. Some songs will show you the way to go. When you're checking out the dance, good songs are sent from man, from God, to help us pass the test. Our love, darling, it's a song we desire. Hands out, you know that some songs tell stories and prophesize. Some songs prophesize warnings from the master to make your soul listen to it and make your learning faster. The devil has a special plan. He making hot songs to send us. Thank God we can turn it around and make good songs within us. Did you know that some songs are turning you back to dust? The only songs that you should hear are the songs that you can trust. We
thank you much.
Waters, who will perform a jazz routine choreographed by Pamela Sayu. No, I'm just kidding. I didn't write that. They wrote this for me, so it's not like I wanted to advertise. Okay. Terry is a student of Holy Spirit School and is currently a member of the Camellia City Tap and Jazz Ensemble. For the past 4 years, Terry has danced and sang with the children's ensemble portion of the Best of Broadway and has performed in local children's theater productions with Broadway Academy, Cisneros Studio, and River City Theater Company. Terry loves to perform. At times, she can be found performing in several productions in the same weekend. Renee is a fifth grader at Caleb Greenwood School and has danced at Broadway Academy since the age of 7. She was a member of Broadway Academy's junior dance company and now with the junior company. Renee loves to participate in the planning of community activities. She has served as a youth advisor to the cultural events coordinator of the Sacramento Children's Festival. She has been a big influence on people, including her grandfather, whom she convinced to return to China after 50 years. A new work entitled The Wall was written by composer Robert McClintock and funded by the Sacramento Metropolitan Arts Commission in 1989 based upon her story and her own journey to China with her grandfather. Feel free to boogie in your seats with this one. Terry and Renee, strike it up!
Thank you.
Okay. Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. First of all, before I forget, I do want to invite you all to stay after. We're going to open up the auditorium, bring out refreshments, so you'll be able to meet the cast, as well as they being able to meet you, which is what we decided that this whole showcase was about, and that will be your opportunity. So please try and stay after, and let's do that, okay? Next, to start off the second half, we have a talented gentleman. His name is Huey Bryant. He is an alumni of Pepperdine University in Malibu, California. He has performed at Disneyland, various clubs in Southern California, and in Oakland. He has traveled to Asia and Europe. Please welcome Mr. Huey Bryant singing "There's a Winner in You."
Thank you.
please tonight. It's my pleasure. Everything's my pleasure. I really want to bring these guys out again. Hot Pursuit, Antoinette and Anthony playing together in an up-tempo song called Never.
Thank you.
weather like that. Well, I'm from Hawaii, so I get weather like that all the time. A little spoiled, a little cold for me. Next, I'd like to introduce Lindsay Fields. She's looking forward to pursuing a career as an accomplished vocalist. She also hopes to follow along the... This is cute. She also hopes to follow along the fingertips of her favorite pianist, Danny. Lindsay recently had the lead role in Odyssey of the Mind, a gate play production of Alice in Omerland. Her group was awarded Best Acting Performance among the Northern California Gates students. Please welcome Lindsay. Please welcome Lindsay Fields singing Wind Beneath My Wings.
Theater in Old Sacramento. Tonight she will be singing Sunday Kind of Love, Carol Bartlett. Sacramento Area Dance Alliance. Hope I can move like them when I'm their age. Let's give it up for the Rhythm Rascals.
Thank you.
Opera and contemporary music.
She has appeared in TV commercials and co-hosted primetime TV program. She toured in the Soviet Union performing for 6 weeks. She is an academic achiever, student body president, and on the honor roll. Her goals are to become a, her goal is to become a performing artist with a law degree. Wow. Please welcome Ms. Trisha Michelle Miles, age 16.
Pleasure to introduce to you singing on stage, our hostess for the evening, Pam Save.
Lipstick worked for line drawings and the cool paper was great for finger painting. When my mother got home, she scolded us and sent Emily home. But she didn't yell and carry on like the time she did when we cut our hair. Emily used to have long, bouncy curls of the Shirley Temple variety. Every night, her mother would roll her hair up in curls, an ordeal which Emily hated. I had pigtails, long, thick braids that hung down. We cut the pigtails first, as they were easy. Emily used my mother's sewing scissors because they were the sharpest pair she could find. She had to use both hands in order to get enough pressure. She cut those pigtails right off while they were still braided. Emily's curls were fun to cut too. I did them one at a time, cutting as close to the scalp as I could, so that the curls could fell to the floor for as long as possible. Now our plan was to glue the hair on my baby sister, who was nearly a year old and still completely bald. We couldn't decide on whether to give her Emily's curls or my pigtail, so we decided to do one half of her head one way and the other half the other way. We found some glue in my father's desk and smeared it all over Sophie's bald head. We stuck the curls into the glue, but they didn't hold as well together as well as we had hoped, so we added more glue. It was hard to keep the hair from sticking to our fingers, and we had to keep wiping our hands all over our clothes. When we tried to glue a pigtail on, it wouldn't stick at all. It was too heavy. So we decided we should unbraid it, glue the individual parts on, and then braid it again after it was dry. We never did find out if this plan would work or not. Sophie got tired of sitting still and started to howl. Mother came in to see what was wrong and howled louder than Sophie. Emily ran home, leaving me to explain by myself. But she was soon back with her cheerful mother, who accused me of being a troublemaker and said that Emily could not play with me anymore. This made my mother angry. She informed Emily's mother that I was never naughty when I was alone, only when I was with Emily. She suggested that Emily was the troublemaker, and I was merely nothing more than an innocent bystander. Our mother soon calmed down and apologized for losing their tempers with one another. They agreed that Emily and I required close supervision when they had off. For the rest of the summer, they watched us with private attention. It wasn't any fun at all.
Lastly, we'd like to bring on someone that you met earlier this evening. Her name is Sharon Iroh. She's going to close the show and perform after the lights go down. Sharon will marry on April 25th to a wonderful man named Mark, who is very supportive of her dreams to one day be a recording artist. She will turn 27 tomorrow. Please welcome Mrs. Sharon Iroh.
After the lights go down, oh baby, there'll be no reason for teasing me so. And when the dancing is through and close will be few, I'll be here sitting with no one but you. And I'll be needing you so. Can cuddle up here with
Vocal room, which is directly attached to the entryway where you entered the theater this evening.